Hello, this is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. I'm towing my Airstream base camp, heading over to Allaire State Park. Salsa Bikes and Brielle Cyclery are doing a demo day, Sunday, March 1st, 2015. It's 10 o'clock in the morning. We have a snowstorm coming at noon. This should make it interesting, so I'm heading over early. I want to ride each and every bike that they're bringing. I heard they're bringing about 30 different bikes, some fat bikes, some regular mountain bikes, full suspension. So I plan on doing a review on the different bikes I ride. And I have my trailer, so I have a place to eat lunch. I have some heat in there. I have a refrigerator, TV, DVD player, stereo, whatever I need to hang out for the duration of the day. I'm excited. I've been waiting for this for a few weeks. And, you know, it's not perfect weather, but hey, I'll ride in any weather. So join me. Okay, so I just arrived here at Allaire State Park. Salsa Bikes is here with Brielle Cyclery. I have my Airstream base camp all set up for today's activities.
Complications from it. Is this yours, bro?
Yeah, man. I have the heat on, got my bike all set up. I can come here and change. I could eat later on a little cooktop. I could even take a nap if needed and watch TV, put a DVD in. So I'm gonna go up to the booth here and see what the process is. These are all different bikes that they have. You give them your driver's license. They'll put your driver's license up so they know which bike you took. You sign in the iPad. They got snacks for everybody here.
So when I got here, it was
right over everything.
Yeah.
So they got here a Beargrease bike, one of their demo bikes.
We got a bunch out at the moment.
You made it back.
Blackborow.
That might be tough. They are, yeah.
Give you an idea how fat the tires are.
I mean, the carbon ones actually are studable.
Mukluk.
So you can add like little metal studs to them, and that helps a ton on the ice.
They do make great bikes, really nice components. This tire is not as fat as the one that was next to it. They have the full suspension here, Bucksaw. But man, is it cold here today. They have the Ram ProMaster van. So let's get in line here and let's sign up for a bike. Okay, so I'm signed in the iPad. I got my driver's license that they're gonna put on the board here, and he's going over to get my bike. And then I'll get geared up in the base camp, and then we'll go for a demo on this bike. Now, what's this one called that you're bringing over?
It's called the Bucksaw.
Okay.
Single digits. Our new fat bike, full suspension.
Nice. I don't clip in. Do you have regular pedals or what?
Yeah, I got some flat pedals. This one I'm actually going to quick throw these on to this guy and get him out of here.
Okay, cool.
And then I'll get you on a medium.
Okay.
It's bigger, this would be a little small.
Okay.
Usually about a medium or a large, medium large?
Medium, yeah. Yep.
Would you buy a blank like that? You do, and I'll just get you some flat.
Okay, thank you.
You can choose whatever pattern you want.
Okay.
Put them in every single hole.
They'll stick real nice.
Okay, perfect.
I'm going to go ahead and stand up. Kind of give it a couple good bounces. And just stay right there. Alright, you want to step on off? 30% sag is where I want it. 25 to 30 up here. It's like made to be, man.
Made to be.
Yeah, that's perfect. How did the seat height feel?
It was fine.
Okay.
It was fine.
All right. And like I said, too, if you want a little bit more air, let me know. I know it's a little icy and slick out. All right. I also have some studded tires I can quick throw on here, too, if it gets to be too slick. Let me know.
Okay. Awesome, man. Up. Thank you.
Enjoy.
I'll see you when I get back.
Have a good time.
Thanks.
One shifter, 11 gears. Use them all.
Okay.
And then if you want to firm up the fork, you can lock her out that way.
Okay.
And you're all set.
All right, man. Thanks.
Our buddy's still on the trip. Saddle.
Let's try it on this ice here. Definitely a lot more grip. Just still have to be cautious, obviously, because it's very slick back here. Don't want to take a nasty spill, but it's a nice full suspension fat bike by Salsa. Still sliding. Maybe if I had studded tires, that would make a difference. But what's nice about a bike like this, you could just make your own trail. You know what I mean? If you just wanted to go up here through the woods, kind of just make your own trail. Something I can't really do on my Trek right now. That's a bit fun. Making our own trail. Still tough. This is ice. This is not snow. This is iced over snow. But if you're into exploring, I've been riding this bike for some time now. I already went trail blazing. Now I'm taking a trail that hasn't had a lot of traffic. It's less icy. But it is still a bit challenging. Shiny ice here. That's a little trippy. See, it's ice here. I don't even see it. I've been just going trailblazing, man, making my own trails. It's better with something like this.
Good luck, man. Wow, that was good. Good time. It's a blast.
Thing's fun as hell, right?
Yeah, I just stayed off the trails. I just made my own.
This is going to be our adventure fat bike with the wider tire and rim than our Mukluk, so this will take you across a super loose trail, whether it's sand or snow or any sort of terrain. You can make your own trail with it. You also have all the same mounts that our Mukluk does. You can run your extra anything cages, extra bottles here, and then we also have a rack and system off the back too if you want to bring more stuff with you.
And how many gears are there?
This is going to be a 2x10 setup.
Okay.
You got two up front, 10 in the back.
Perfect.
And it comes with our alternator dropouts, so you can run it single speed, you can run it geared, and give you that option.
Awesome. I'm excited. I'm going to take it out.
Sounds good. Like I said, I think I have about three up front. Four in the back. Oh,
okay, I know what you're talking about.
That'll be perfect. So. Okay, let's take this one for a spin here. Try a different trail. Now, you can definitely tell the difference. This being a hard tail, I've been riding full suspension for a while now. But it does handle this ice a little bit better with the wider tire than the Bucksaw I was riding. Got the start Strava. Keep track of how far I've ridden on each one. Yeah, you can really rip it around them turns. This area is a little tricky. This is one sheet of ice, but you can ride up on the bank with this bike. Tires are so fat. Blast right through. Now you can go down these hills sideways. Wow, made that easy. I mean, I am putting a lot more effort into it for several reasons. For one, the tires are so damn wide. Two, I'm riding in snow. My heart rate is up there. When you ride on banks, it does want to skid out. Oh, It does make it a little bit easier. I feel a little bit more confident on this bike than the last one. I'm definitely more confident on this versus my Trek Remini 29er. Take this path here. Yeehaw! Over the bridge. Up the bank. Where you need these grippy tires to go up these hills. Oh, I almost made it up. If I was a little bit more prepared, I could have. Wow, this bike is a lot of fun. Get some studs in these tires and get a great setup for today. There is going to be super slick coming up. Be careful. Wouldn't be able to do that on any other bike but this Salsa. Wow, that was really cool. That would have been so damn sketchy with my other bike.
Completely up to you.
Okay, and this bike is what they call it again?
This is the Mukluk.
Okay, and it's got a front suspension, hardtail.
Yep, 2x10 setup, hardtail aluminum.
Okay.
With the Bluto suspension fork.
Nice.
80 mil rim, 4-inch tire, so it's right in the middle of the road. You know, you can go get your Blackborow, which you just rode, a little bit wider and bigger, and you got your Beargrease, which is a little bit narrower and sleeker. So.
Awesome. Different terrain now. We got a little bit of powder on top of the ice, so I'll definitely take it easy.
Yeah.
Don't know what's underneath now.
Yeah. I know, that's the trick.
All right, I'll see you in a few.
All right, sounds good. Dude, it likes the ice in the bird.
I know. Now it's covered, so.
Yeah.
I was on this trail before. It's mostly powder. Where? Okay. Are you guys heading back or are you cutting through that way?
We're heading back.
All right. You're clear. Rip it. You good?
I got three back.
Three back? All
yep.
Right.
Rider up.
Clear.
I got two more behind me.
All right. It's a hot trail because this one's a little clearer. how far they are back. We'll see. Very nice bike. Great handling. It's covering all the slick ice. I don't know where it is anymore. That area is slick there. Definitely wouldn't want to clip in today. Got to be able to pick your foot up really quick. Like there. Save myself. If you're not sure how slick an area is, let's take a look and see how many people walk the road around the low spot. And you'll know there's probably ice underneath it. Really nice setup here. Whew. Okay, this Salsa Mukluk bike is performing very well. It's a hard tail front suspension. There's some areas of ice underneath the snow that obviously it's not doing well on. But I kind of remember where those areas were. Snowing now, so we're getting powder on top of the ice. So I'm just riding over my old track. I'm prepared. I got my boot down over around the turn to help brace me if I slip. So what do we have here?
We got the Blackborow. It's like the one that you rode earlier.
Okay.
But now this one's going to have a Dillinger 5 studded tire. About 250 studs per tire. Aluminum bed, carbide tip.
I see that, okay. It's been perfect for a day like today. And
yeah, all that hidden ice. Yeah, you want a little bit of insurance. So, won't exactly make you Superman, but
no,
it should keep you upright.
Awesome.
Yeah, see if that feels all right.
Yeah, perfect.
All right.
I'll see you. I can immediately see the difference here. I have a little bit more grip now with these studs. Tires. Oh yeah. I mean, it's still gonna slip a little bit. In case you're just viewing in, this is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. I'm here at Allaire State Park in Howell Township, New Jersey. Salsa Bikes is here. They have a demo day, and they have a full line of bikes for you to ride. Now, we have a lot of ice underneath the snow, the powder here, that makes it very, very slick. So I'm being extra cautious today. This bike's gonna handle a little bit better than some of the other bikes I was riding before, but it still is pretty slick on that ice areas. This trail here is all mostly powder, so you go pretty fast through it. So if you're considering buying a new bike, check with your local bike store. A lot of the manufacturers have bike demo days, and you can go out and ride their full line of bikes all in one day, so you could know and decide which bike is the best fit for you. We'll also give you tips on how to dial it in. Allaire State Park has over 100 miles of trails for the ride. A lot of single track trails. There's horseback riding here, hiking, biking, you name it. I try to catch up with this group here. I left my glasses in the Airstream base camp. So I'm squinting because of snow. I'm actually gonna take this other trail. Ah, this is great. Oh, this is wonderful. I was slipping and sliding through this before. Wow. That area was very hard to maneuver before. If this looks familiar, I had some other videos with this same trail before, earlier today. I wanted to try each bike in the same trail to kind of compare them. Man, this is a really nice setup for no suspension. These studs here really helping out a little bit. How you doing?
Good. Yeah.
Had a great day here at the Salsa Cycle Demo Day at Allaire State Park in Wall Township, New Jersey. Heading back to the base camp now. The crew at Briel Cyclery and Salsa are absolutely incredible. I got to try all the different bikes that I want. I got a lot of education here today. I would consider this perfect riding condition for a fat bike. A little slick underneath the snow, but other than that, I was very careful. I didn't take any spills today, but let's head back into the Airstream base camp and warm up and put our gear away. It's nice and cozy here with the space heater. Got my Camelback here on the wall. Some extra socks. Got a stereo system up front, TV with a DVD player, coat hook. I got a Goal Zero Lighthouse 250 Lantern. Got your Leatherman. Got my wet gloves hanging up here on the gear pole. My helmet with my Lezine light. TV's hooked up to an inverter system. Inverter system runs off the battery. And then I have a Zamp solar charging system on the roof. 100 watt flexible panel. I have a Waco by Dometic. Refrigerator that runs off 12 volt or electricity. Salsa hooked me up with a sticker, a catalog, and a t-shirt. This was all free today. I have my stainless steel cup holders here that I did a video on earlier. This folds into bed. They also fold up so you can ride a quad inside. I have all my GoPro gear all ready to go. There's air conditioning up front, storage, single burner cooktop, a sink, a little sleeping bag. Has this storage above. Has a little skylight, and then these windows open for ventilation.
So this worked out great on a day like today. It's 28 degrees inside right now with the back door open with just this heater. It's about 68 degrees. Unbelievable. Very low consumption power here. I got LED lights inside. Hope you enjoyed my video. This is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. Please like this video, subscribe, share. I love it. I'll see you soon.